Hello, everybody. It's Eric. It's Chaos, whatever you want to call me. And I have another coffee house video for you. So it's been almost 2 weeks since my last video. And first off, I just want to apologize to you guys for that. Just got way too busy for my own good. Real life stuff, work stuff, a little sickness, a little of this, a little of that. But I am back. And so I'm doing another coffee house video. I did the pilot for this series about 2 weeks ago and did a Pearl Jam cover. And was pretty curious to see about the response that it was going to get. And it turns out you guys seem to really like it. Got a really strong response. Got some of the best ratings that I've had so far. As far as, you know, videos that haven't been promoted on somebody else's channel or shouted out or something like that. So, thanks so much for the support on this. And so I'm going to give you guys what you want to see. And I'm going to talk a little bit about the song that I'm going to do tonight in a little bit. But just wanted to catch up with you guys a little bit. I think I'm probably going to stop doing the Sunday Night Black Ops series just because I have so much other stuff I want to do. And I only have time to do about one or two videos a week. And honestly, those seem to be my least watched and rated videos. So I'll just catch up with you guys before the coffee house thing, right? Sounds good? Great. So gameplay here is just a little domination, a little double dog deliciousness. Pretty fun stuff to watch. Got it last week on one of my speed sessions. You know, I only get about 5 or 6 hours a week to play Black Ops. And so it's always nice when you get a pretty strong game like this. But pretty good game. You know, I do try to get the B flag early here, but I was sort of screaming at my teammates. Was in with some randoms, and me and one other guy were trying to get B against, you know, the whole other team trying to get B. That never works. So I said, all right, I'm just going to flank around and get some dogs, and we'll win that way. And things turn out pretty good. So enough of the gameplay. So just want to check in with you guys. Here's what's coming up for my channel. I've got like 3 things that I'm going to do soon. I'm going to start work on my ridiculous COD rap parody this week. It's going to be called Gommel. And I got a special guest who's going to work with me on it. I've got actually another guy who's going to do some help with some of the video content. I think it's going to be really funny. You know, it's really just sort of like going to be a lighthearted poke at COD raps, and you know, it's there's no beefs, it's just a joke. So hopefully everybody's gonna take it for what it is. I think it's gonna be pretty funny stuff. Probably gonna be doing another theater mode video soon, and yeah, I think that's, you know, probably in the next 2 weeks that's what you can expect from me, and maybe we'll do another coffee house vid. So for these coffee house videos, if you guys have any suggestions, if there's a song you want me to tackle, please let me know. Leave a suggestion in the comments below. Follow me on Twitter if you're not already doing that, and you can tweet suggestions at me. I do look at all the songs. I had some suggestions last week. I didn't end up going with any of them, but don't take it personally. It doesn't mean I didn't like the song. It just means maybe there was something else I wanted to do. And so tonight, we can, you know, talk about what I'm doing. This song is called Hallelujah, and it was originally written by a Canadian singer-songwriter named Leonard Cohen. Now, I'm going to take a wild guess here that almost none of you have ever heard of this guy. And, you know, he's sort of more revered in the musician circles and the singer-songwriter circles than any kind of mainstream success. He's kind of a folky, gospely sort of guy, and he's got this, like, gravelly, smoky voice and some pretty cool lyrics. I'm not going to say he's like Tom Waits, but I guess it's sort of in that same kind of category where it's a little bit esoteric. Most people won't know about him. But the version of this song that I'm going to do is actually based off of the Jeff Buckley cover version. So it's a cover within a cover, so there's a little inception for you there. So the Jeff Buckley version, you know, I did a Q&A video about 5 weeks ago, I think, and I introduced you guys to Jeff and told you to go check him out. So if you haven't done that yet, do yourself a favor. Go listen to some Jeff Buckley. Did you see me just fail on that sound whoring there? It was embarrassing. Check out Jeff Buckley. He's amazing. And so the reason I wanted to do this song is it's a really... just an amazing song, first off. You know, I think there's probably hundreds of people who have covered this song, and it might sound familiar to you when you hear it. You know, you'd always know when there's, you know, hundreds of people covering a song that it's a pretty special tune. And so I'm not a religious guy. And let me say, you know, right there, if you are religious, if you have faith, if that makes you a better person and that makes you happy, then... that's awesome. And anyone who doesn't like it should kiss your ass, and you should tell them that. But I personally am, you know, I'm not a religious man. But this song kind of speaks to me on a spiritual level, I have to say, and really touches me. And, you know, there's a lot of references in this song to the Bible and to religion. But, you know, there's also maybe a little question of agnosticism in there. So it really sort of touches me on a spiritual level. It affects me very deeply. So I wanted to share it with you guys. So I'm going to put the video up now and say goodbye to you. Thanks so much for your support, as always. I love you guys. And I'm now doing my commentaries on my Turtle Beach PX21s. A lot of people were complaining it was too bassy, too compressed. So if you don't like it, let me know. I can go back to the studio mic. But let's get the song going. Later, guys.
not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody you've seen alive.